Bengals. You got.
Division. When the bell rings, the referee in charge will be Jay Nady. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the purple corner, he's wearing black trunks with white lettering and weighed in at 237 pounds. Hailing from Augusta, Georgia, please welcome Cedric Big Buck Fields. And his opponent, fighting out of the black corner, he's wearing white trunks and also weighed in at exactly 237 pounds. Coming to us from the great fighting city of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, here is Gerald the Jedi Nobles.
All right, Jay Nady gives him the last second introductions, and we're ready to go. Gerald Nobles in the white trunks. Look at him there. The opposite corner, Cedric Fields in the all black trunks. Nobles unbeaten, 18-0, 15 KOs. So look for the early power of Gerald Nobles. Nobles to be a little bit taller than these 6'1 Fields.
One thing about Nobles, like I say, he looks very confident. He's got his hands at his waist already. You know, he's taking Cedric Fields as an opponent. That's very dangerous sometimes because some of these guys have nothing to lose, have everything to gain. They're very dangerous with their punching power.
Left hand held very low by Nobles, who's trying to establish that shotgun jab.
He's exuding a lot of confidence right now. He's trying to show Fields that, you know, hey, I'm the biggest, stronger guy, you know, and the bottom line is very, very careful, especially this early in the fight. You remember, Fields does have 9 knockouts.
Gerald Nobles coming off a victory, obviously, 18-0, December the 14th, a TKO in round number 1. Fields coming off a TKO in round number 2 in December over John Dixon. So both of these guys coming off wins. And again, Fields a little bit better than his record of 12-11. He's trying to stay above 500. Jab to the body by Nobles, trying to hook off that jab.
It's like the rule says, you know, Fields, the bottom line is that who he's lost to. You know, sometimes a guy can have a record like Freddie Pendleton had, 15 wins, 15 losses, but he lost the world championship caliber opposition. And sometimes that makes a difference. Fields actually doesn't look like an opponent here tonight. He looks like a very good fighter, like he's got some abilities.
Well, he has beaten the likes of Shannon Briggs in April, and he looked pretty good against Oleg Miskayev and Jamil McClain, who we'll see a little bit later on. And he's fought former champion Oliver McCall and went the distance with him. So quality of opposition you got to give to Fields. He's taking a few shots right now from Nobles in the white trunks.
The biggest mistake Nobles can make is that he's trying to get a knockout early, fatigue and get tired and get caught by Fields in the later rounds. Because remember, we are going 10 rounds here.
Scheduled for 10 rounds. He's, by the way, good point. He's never been 10 rounds, said Gerald Nobles.
He used to knockouts, like I said. It's probably some guys that are used to knockouts. When they hit the first guy on the chin that doesn't lay down, they get shocked and they don't know what to do. So I want to see what happens if he fills with a good shot and Fields takes it.
Cedric has been 10 rounds a couple of times during his career and, again, fought the better opposition. You know, Nobles may be unbeaten. Nice uppercut there by Gerald Nobles. He may be unbeaten, but I can see one thing he can improve on right now, and that's his physique. A little flabby.
Well, conditioning is always usually the case with heavyweights because they don't have to make a weight. So most heavyweights are out of shape most of the time. Because, like I said, there's no weight restriction. I believe there should be a weight restriction. Okay? And it should be super heavyweights and heavyweights. But tonight, Nobles has to be in here in shape and ready to go. But that one-punch knockout seems like it's not going to happen in the first round.
Round number 1 scheduled for 10 is in the banks. Have to give that round. I give
Jeff Key, right? Throw your right hand. Sit back, let me relax. I'm going to let you fucking come. I want to jab in your chest. And it's in anywhere, but I want you stepping on it with pressure. Don't let get you fucking come. You understand what I'm saying?
Control the action.
Get something off on it. Get your jab.
Trying to get a knockout. Just on that base, I scored like a six.
Your jab. Right hand. Jab. One, two. You're inside. Just go back to your body. Finish on top. Stop letting it get you come.
Well, here you got to hit the replay again. Dicks to the body. That punch was a little low. It was kind of actually under the belt line. So the way I see it was, you know, hey, that's a little hip shot, a little cheap shot. Let's see if Fields gets him back for it.
All right, round two, scheduled for 10. Heavyweights, Gerald Nobles in the all-white trunks, Cedric Fields in the all-black trunks. At the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino inside the joint. A couple of nice left jabs by Gerald Nobles. There he hooks off the jab. Lance really going to the body of Cedric Fields, isn't he?
Yeah, but a few of those shots are drifting a little bit on the waistline.
There's a big hook by Nobles. Gets hit with the right hand by Fields. Now Jay Nady's going to warn Gerald Nobles.
I've been seeing that from round one. Like I said, it's a good antic to work to slow your man down, but he's been doing it quite often, back to back, back to back, hitting low. You know, and no matter how you look at it, it's an illegal punch.
Jay Nady giving Fields some time to recuperate.
He can get it after up to 5 minutes.
Right.
You get the chance to sit down. I don't think he needs it at this point in the fight, but if I would allow Nobles to go low some more, and maybe they get a point on it.
All right, the action continues here in round number two. Nobles trying to establish that jab, hooking off the jab. Left hand is awful low. Nobles, you can, he's exuding that confidence you mentioned, showing no respect for Fields, who has a pretty decent right hand. I think Fields should try to capitalize on that hand being low.
I'll tell you, you know, he's exuding a lot of his cockiness and his confidence, but, you know, he's not doing nothing wrong.
There's a right hand by Nobles. It lands slightly.
Fields is landing. He's touching him. He's touching with shots. You know, he's not exactly out of the fight. He didn't exactly get buckled yet by any big punches. And, like I said, the biggest mistake a young fighter can make with as many knockouts that Nobles has is trying to get a knockout this early in the fight.
You see that Nobles has Fields against the corner, landing some pretty decent shots. Some of those blocked. There's a left hook that partially lands.
He's definitely landing a bigger shot right now.
There's a nice two good left hooks by Gerald Nobles. Left hook to the body by Nobles.
Fields, I tell you, I give him credit. He's not even buckling from the shots. There's no signs of any wear and tear to go another low blow. I know, like I said,
I think we're going to take a point away here. Jay Nady's already applied the punch. I think he's going to, there it is. He takes a point.
Oh. That ruins the round right there. He had a 10-9 round going for his favor. Now it's a 9-9 round. Now, if Bill comes back somehow in the later part of this round, he'll go to low blow. You look at it right here. Right on the belt line, it's kind of questionable. You know, when you catch the belt line, the rule is underneath the belt line. But I guess being the belt line's a little high, you can take a point away.
Unless you're Lennox Lewis, who wears that belt way up to his chest bone.
Unless you're Galana, and you're going to reach him low, that low.
All right, action continues. There's a right and a left by Cedric Fields. Nobles with the white trunks turned pro in 1995. 54 total rounds of boxing. Never been 10, as we mentioned earlier in the contest. Kevin said to look to that. Oh, there's another low blow by Gerald Nobles. That one on the side. That'll slow those legs down later on. There's another
low blow.
He's
hitting so low. I mean, what's crazy is hitting on the front. The 10-8 round. I mean, 9-8 round now. I mean, he's winning the round. He's hitting low. He's headbutting. I mean.
Well, look at Cedric Fields. He's down in some pain. And this fight could be stopped if there's any more low blow activity by Gerald Nobles. Let's look at this again. You see him in the white. Nobles, there's his.
They're going to have low blow.
Low blow.
He hits him with the shot there. He's headbutting a little bit. I mean, with such a guy with such a great record, maybe some of these knockouts have happened with low blow. And maybe this referee never caught him.
Those were low, no doubt about it. Maybe a little bit of acting on the part of us.
How to say, milk it for everything it's worth, right?
Right.
Get a minute rest. He's getting hit with the bigger shots. He does have a 500 record almost, you know, so, hey. Who knows? If Nobles keeps throwing those shots the way he is, he's going to get disqualified and get his first loss.
All right, Gerald Nobles, again, we mentioned 18-0, 15 KOs, but on the verge of being disqualified. right here if he lands another low blow. There's the jab of Nobles. And it's been a pretty decent round for him other than those low blows. End of the round.
I still have to score that round 9-8. I mean, because he had 2 points taken away. He was winning the round. He was winning the fight. He was having the bigger shots.
Every now and then, you're pressing downstairs, all right? Take a deep breath. There you go. All right, you're on point, okay? You're on point. But you're sitting inside and not doing that when you get there. I want you finishing on low. No, I know, but still no. He's trying to get out of this. Trying to find a way out of this shit, right? More shot, more than one. What's the combination coming? What about the jab? Let's win that door.
Time.
Why is the danger of losing
the
disqualification? Yes, sir. Look good, man. He's trying to get out of it, Joe. Don't stay upstairs. Hit him on his arms and his head. Hit him on his fucking arms. Okay? Make his arm.
First round, I thought Noble lost. And the second round, he had 2 points deducted, which made it a 9-8 round. I'm telling you, he's better stop picking those punches up or he's going to disqualify.
All right. Heavyweight explosion, round number three, scheduled for 10. Gerald Nobles unbeaten in the white trunks. Cedric Fields with a record of 12-11. 9, though, via the KO route in the all-black trunks. Nice combination to start out the round by Gerald Nobles. There's a left and a right by Nobles. He's been effective with that left jab. He's got his left hand held very low. Could that have anything to do with when he brings up that hook, why it's straying low, because it's starting out lower than normal?
Well, he's trying to get a body shot in, and what happens is the shorts of Fields is very high, a little bit, a little higher. There he goes again, low blow.
Now that one was looked to be right on the borderline.
I think Fields acting a little bit too here.
Yeah, I agree with you. Maybe trying to milk this.
He can milk it, but you know, the problem is that Noble's given an opportunity to do this. So, you know, what he's got to do is stay off the body. I would tell him, punch him in the chest. Don't punch him in the stomach anymore. Keep punches higher. I mean, if Fields wants to claim that he can't fight the rest of the fight, that Nobles will be disqualified in this fight.
Right now, yeah, let's look at it.
Oh, very low blow. It was like kind of an upward motion. I don't think it was that hard of a shot. I think he's overreacting to the punch, but he is milking it for everything it's worth, and he can do that.
And it almost looked like Nobles didn't throw that shot with a lot of bad intentions. I think he's already a bit concerned about all of the low blows.
Not that this makes it correct.
Right.
But if it was me, I would get up, and Nobles would have one coming back. You know what I mean? I mean, the way you pretty much when you stop a fight. Guy from hitting low shots is you pay him back on the low shots yourself.
Fighter can have up to 5 minutes. Cedric Fields looks to be taking most of that. Gets his mouthpiece in. We're in round three. Already a couple of points deducted in the last round. I would think one more low blow, and Nobles would be disqualified.
Yeah, looking for his first loss. And he's better stay there. Like I said, you know what? This is what happens to young fighters that can't get a knockout. He's very cocky, very arrogant. He has a good record. But the point is he doesn't have no way to implement what he does. He's not coming in off a jab. He's supposed to be breaking down Cedric Fields right now. With a jab, straight right hands, punch to the body, bring it back to the head. Instead, he's getting all his cockiness, all his flamboyant punches, looping his punches, going wide, going wild, and now he's in jeopardy of losing his fight.
All right, you can see the trepidation on the face of Nobles, but you know, now Cedric Fields is complaining about just about everything.
Well, he can. Nobles is being very wild right now, even though he may look a little sharp with it too. He has more experience. He's undefeated. Good record, but right now he's doing a lot of things that are very uncalled for with the cockiness and arrogance. He's taking Fields for granted.
Nobles might want to abandon that body attack that's produced those three point deductions for low blows. Again, he appears to be the better of the two fighters. He's unbeaten, but again on the verge of a DQ because of those low blows. Fields trying to come on a little bit here.
I don't think Nobles is used to a guy that's able to land his shots. And Fields is landing some punches here. He does land, not often, here goes a straight right hand. He landed a straight right hand, and Fields, I think, is getting a little bit embarrassed by the shots that he's getting caught with because his hands are down. But he's not taking Fields seriously, and this is why he's getting hit.
Well, we also mentioned that Cedric Fields has taken on Oliver Paul, like Miskayev. He's beaten Shannon Briggs, so he's fought some good opposition. He has been the 10-round distance before. Again, Nobles in a few rounds will be into the territory he hasn't been into. Nice combination by Fields, but he takes a second to admire his work. Nobles with a left hook.
Nobles in for a real fight this time. I think he's starting to realize that, you know what, all the stuff that he's been doing with his last 18 opponents ain't working here. He's in the ring with a workhorse, a guy that knows how to take shots and give his own.
He's slowing down a little bit, Nobles, too. Mouth open. He's starting to get hit with those right hands over the top by Cedric Field.
He's getting hit with both hands, to the truth, Smitty. I mean, you know, he's in a fight. He's learning that, hey, this game is not about the easy opponents.
Good combination by Fields as we come to the end of the round. Pretty decent round for Cedric Field. Look at the corner.
Left hook, right hand, step to and roll. Left hook, right hand again. You backing up, he walking to you. I want you to suck him into your right hand. Still with the right hand when he walk, when he follow.
You see Noble throwing the point. I believe that here, you see him using his head. He's headbutting, and Cedric Fields complaining about the headbutt. Overhand left. You know, Cedric Fields says, hey, that didn't mean nothing.
All right, round four scheduled for 10. Gerald Nobles, unbeaten Gerald Nobles. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. The all-white comes out with a little combination. Cedric Fields in the all-black trunks. Both of these guys coming off wins. A lot of low blows. I think there have been, what, 3 or 4 points taken away for low blows.
I think as this fight goes on and as we get to later rounds and Nobles gets a little more frustrated, I believe the style that he's fighting in right now is out of frustration. It's not because he feels confident and comfortable.
Well, Cedric Fields counterpunching, doing a nice job, starting to land that short right hand over the top. Just taking his time, very relaxed. He's tasted the canvas a lot. That's courtesy of those low blows by Nobles. But again, he looks very relaxed. Now he's trying Fields just to establish his own left jab.
He does got 9 knockouts, Fields. So you got to remember, Fields can punch. He knows he's got a nice right hand. It's not a great right hand, but it's a nice right hand. And as this fight goes on and Nobles keeps his hands down like that, he gives more of a chance of getting caught with something big.
We're at the joint inside the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino here in Las Vegas. Heavyweight explosion action. James Smith along with Kevin Kelly, former 2-time featherweight champion.
Thank you, Smitty.
Of
I like
the world.
That. I enjoy that. I take credit for doing it twice. Makes it that
you
nice.
You deserve that credit, for especially in that division. All right, Noble's trying to establish that left jab. Moving around, bouncing around, lands a lead right hand. All of a sudden, he's on his toes for a few seconds there.
See, the big thing Nobles is doing, he lands a straight punch or a big hook or a big right hand, and then he waits for Fields to hit the floor. And he doesn't see it happening, so now he has to change gears. He needs to go back to the jab. It's called touching. There he goes. Hits on a big punch, steps back, and looks at his work. Don't admire your work.
And that's because so many of his opponents have, fallen from those shots. 15 knockouts, as we mentioned. There's a looping shot that misses by Nobles.
Well, it's a new day. Either Nobles can't punch as hard as his record shows, or Fields has a tremendous chin.
And we clearly do know that Fields has, again, been in with the better opposition. And we also know that we're in round four now, that Nobles has not been... the 10-round limit. He has been 8-round a couple of times, but you're right. He's had so many knockouts, 15 knockouts. He's used to these guys going down from his arsenal, and the only time Fields has really shown any inclination of going down is from the low blows. The right hand to the body by
Fields. Fields is going to be bothered by any punches that Nobles is throwing at any time. I haven't seen him buckle yet. I haven't seen him, like, wince. So, he's been in the ring, like I said, with some big punches already, and he's used to punching power.
10 seconds to go here in round number 4. Fields trying to steal the end of this round. Nobles ducks under a shot. And Fields misses with a shot. Difficult round to score.
I actually gave that round. Finally, I gave a round to Nobles. No points deducted. Finally, he did something to me that was correct. He started initiating the action. He still got his hands down. He's still giving Fields an opportunity to catch him with a big right hand and actually get knocked out himself and get the first blemish on his right hand. And if he continues to blow blow, he'll DQ. So right now, like I said, let the saga continue, let the drama begin.
Well, you see a look at Cedric Fields in the corner there. And he's been a pro since 1997. with any bad intentions, Cedric Fields. And it maybe he's saving himself, knowing Nobles has never been the 10-round limit, but Fields needs to start turning over some power shots.
The biggest thing Fields needs right now to do is he's jabbing nicely, but he has to push the jab instead of just stick it out there. Because what Nobles is doing is coming over the top of that jab, and that's how he's landing his big punches. Right there, Fields needs to push off the back foot, shoot the jabs. He's doing it right there, but he steps back. That takes away the leverage of a fighter. It takes away the punching power of a fighter. If you also look at the footwork of both men, Nobles seems to be stepping. He's looking like he wants to step lefty or commit righty, and he's doing his little dancing around the ring like he's Muhammad Ali with his hands at his side. To stop that, all Fields has to do is throw a straight right hand. Just stop all that dance movement.
There's a left hook by Nobles that landed. I think Nobles is out slicking himself just a little bit. I think at this point in his career, he should stick to the, you know, more in improving upon the skills. Again, the left hand has been held low the entire fight. You see it back there again now.
The thing they say, if you make a man miss, you should make him pay. Nobles is not doing that. He's actually admiring his work. He's light. He just made Fields miss a punch, and he didn't counter. Instead, he gets hit with a nice little left jab, and Fields keep coming forward. We're going to see as this fight continues what kind of fighter Nobles really is.
Well, both men seem to be content not to lose the round rather than to really convincingly try to win the round, and nobody's really trying to really, establish any dominance here. Gerald Nobles, again, lands a couple of nice lefts from time to time. There it is again, but it's one at a time. Here's a body shot, and that one did not stray low. Fields attempted to hook off that, missed. There's that jab. You see it's very effective, but it's one at a time.
It's too inconsistent. It's not all the time. And he has to be backing Fields up. He's not backing Fields up. He's backing up after he's popping the jab. Judges don't look at his active aggression. Like I said, there he is. Noble gets hit again with a right hand and a left hook. So, with his hands down.
I don't know how effective the aggression is of Fields, but you're right. He is the one trying to come forward. Again, Noble's landing the better punches, though, this round. Again, that left jab in the face of Cedric Fields. It would think he should try to turn that right hand over it to Gerald Nobles. It is landing the left effectively. He should turn that right hand over, and I think it would find a home on Cedric Fields. 45 seconds left to go. Round number 5 scheduled for 10 from the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Heavyweight explosion. James Smith along with Kevin Kelly.
Well, I tell you, you're starting to see here, you're starting to see Nobles actually starting to initiate some punching. He's actually starting to get away out of the way of punches, making Fields miss some punches, finally. Still, I don't like the idea his hands are down because, you know, you leave too many chances to get hit yourself.
And Nobles avoids a shot. Fields with a light right hand. There's a left hook that lands by Cedric Fields. But he had his head down when it took place. And that's another round I give to Gerald Nobles. Thought he landed the nice left jab. Couple of right hands, moved well, and I give him the round.
Right now, I give him a round. I got the fight dead even at this point because of all the bad actions. I mean, yeah, 2 points taken away in the second round. I gave the first round to Cedric Fields. I gave, the last 3 rounds, I gave him to Gerald Nobles. He's starting to implement attack. He's starting to get his aggression going. He's starting to go forward. He's starting to do what he has to do. This is what I'm talking about. This is the action that Gerald Nobles needs to win this fight. But he still got those hands down, and that leaves a lot of drama for mistake to happen.
Close fight. Again, 3 points taken away from Gerald Nobles for low blows. You look at Nobles as we prepare for round number 6. It's 10-rounder. See Nobles again moving around the ring. Looks like he has pretty decent movement when he utilizes it. But again, with everything he pretty much does, as you mentioned, Kevin, he's inconsistent.
He's very inconsistent. I mean, he jabs, but when he gets hit with a jab, he don't bring his hand up. He's got to realize that, that might be working for him right at this moment. But as he goes, steps up to, better opposition, that won't work.
There's a right hand by Nobles that landed. You see, and there Fields comes back with a nice left hook. I think Nobles thought he hurt him. There's a big right hand and a left hook by Nobles trying to land the uppercut.
Nobles been
to not get careless, because I see him very susceptible to a left hook by Fields. And Fields been around a lot of fighters, so, you know, like I said, I'm thinking right now that, you know, with guys like the Black Rhino, Kirk Johnson, Chris Broad out there, even Maskev, that there's a lot of work to me that Gerald Noble needs.
There's a left and a right by Nobles, but he's having a good round here in round number six. Some swelling around the right eye there of Cedric Fields. Right hand by Nobles. Left hook lands by Fields, coming, trying to come back a little bit now. The mouth wide open of Gerald Nobles, and you wonder whether fatigue might start to set in here. Again, he's never been 10 rounds.
Like I said, he's got a lot of knockouts on his record. So, you know, he's never been in the ring with a workhorse like Fields. Fields is a workhorse. He's been in the game for a while. He's been around for a while. He's been in the ring with some serious fighters. So, you know, Shannon Briggs and stuff like that. So Fields knows what it's like to be in there for 10 rounds.
A couple of body shots by Nobles. He got to be careful thinking back to all those points that were taken away. Oh, there's a left hook in. I don't know. That one was so close. And it just appears to me, though, that Cedric Fields is going to try to take advantage of this. I'd like to see another angle of that.
Well, he's going to milk it if he can. He's definitely going to milk it if he can. If he can get away with milking this one, of course. I mean, you know, he's looking right now. He knows the fight's very close.
Let's take a look here and see if this. You see, Noble's been in position and throw. You know what? That's right on the borderline.
I'm on the borderline. I think he's milking it right now. It was a stomach shot. Either he's hurt from a stomach shot, or it was right on. I mean, you know, right now, John Noble's his undefeated record's on the line right now.
Look how high though he has that protector. See it right now, it's distorted a little bit. He's got it way up high. I think what Jay Nady needs to do is really establish, okay, where you can hit it and where you can.
He's not taking a point away, I don't believe.
I didn't see a motion to the judges to take a point away, but the action resumes.
He didn't take a point away, so I believe right now what's going on is that, you know, like I said, Fields right now, it seems like it's woke him up. He's starting to do a lot, he's a lot busier now, he's starting to reach his punches out there.
Well, he goes down and he withers in pain, but then he jumps right back up and resumes the action. So
it shows that he's acting. You know? There's no actors in the audience, and he's trying to get a movie wrong.
A little bit of Clint Eastwood, I think, in the part of Cedric Fields.
There have been some chances guys have won titles like that. Koji has beaten Randall like that, and Santana beat Terry Norris.
Right, laying down, yeah.
So there have been some titles won laying on the canvas.
All right, Gerald Noble's in the white. Again, winning the round, but having problems with the low blows. Cedric Fields, again, not doing much this round except catching some a lot of left jabs by Nobles.
Nobles with this round, but like I said, his mouth's starting to be wide open. His hands are down. That could be a sign of fatigue right there, just his hands being down.
Here at the end of the round, nice left hook by Cedric Fields. It seems like when he hears that 10-second warning, he makes a big move. He raises his hand, so he's obviously recovered. Now, I would imagine that they didn't take a point. I didn't see Nady take a point away. And if he didn't take a point away, I'm going to give that round to Gerald Noble as well. I don't think he's doing a whole lot more than Fields, but he's doing just enough, in my opinion, to win the round, and Cedric doing just enough to lose the round.
They didn't take a point away from him. It wasn't a low blow, it was an initiative low blow. But the way I see it right now is that, you know, right now, if you look at the fight, the way the fight's going, it seems like Fields is starting to slow down. Noble's starting to pick up. He's finding his match. I think he's starting to fatigue, though, because he's used to getting knockouts. And he hasn't got a knockout yet.
Gerald Noble's Cedric Fields. He said they were pretty evenly matched despite the record of Cedric Fields. 12-11. He's better than that record. He's proving that to Gerald Nobles, who came in here, Nobles did, at 18-0 with 15 KOs. And he's getting close to being in that distance that he hasn't tasted before. He's been 8 rounds twice. This one's scheduled for 10. We're in round number 7 from the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas inside the joint. James Smith along with Kevin Kelly. Heavyweight explosion action. We haven't seen any real explosive action except for some low blows and maybe a little bit of acting by Cedric Fields.
Well, the big thing about Cedric Fields, like I said, he's got to win this fight on his feet, not on the canvas. And he's trying to win on the canvas right now. He's starting to realize that he's starting to slow down. Instead of, you know, like I said, he's throwing a jab. It's here and there. It's inactive sometimes. But Noble's given him more than enough opportunity to win this fight. And he hasn't taken advantage of it
at
all.
Yeah, you're absolutely. Look at the, almost looks like a sparring session for Cedric Fields. I mean, he's obviously at times landing the counter right and throwing some jabs, but he just doesn't, there's a nice right hand by Fields, but nothing with bad intentions. He just doesn't appear to be totally motivated until he gets hit with those low blows.
Well, what happens sometimes is that guys with records like Fields, you know, he's 12 wins with 11 losses, what happens is they start getting to the Spartan mentality because they're not used to winning fights, they're used to losing fights. So instead of trying to win a fight, they just want to survive.
And almost a situation where they do just enough instead of the win, just enough to lose a fight or a round in this case.
Exactly. I mean, in the beginning, it was Jesse Jackson. He had a little bit of hope. Now he ain't got no hope, you know? And, he was hoping maybe that he can get it winning on the canvas by Nobles getting disqualified. But Nobles has been keeping his punches up at the head, not low by the groin area. So I think, you know, right now I'm looking to see if on how Nobles carries this fight as far as the next three rounds.
There's Nobles utilizing that left uppercut, and then you see it again, and then trying to come up with the overhand right.
He's the quicker of the two Nobles. Got faster hands,
and he moves
reflexes.
Well. When he moves, Kevin, he moves well. But he just is so inconsistent with it. I don't know. I mentioned early on that you can look at his conditioning and see that he's a guy who could be and should be in better condition. A little bit of flab around the chest area. There's a nice combination by Nobles. Again, utilizing that hooker cut, if you will, that Razor Ruddock used to utilize. Trying to bring the head up for the right hand to come over the top.
The big thing with those hands being down like that, his condition is definitely a question mark. I mean, I believe that his hands being down, mouth being wide open, his jaw getting broken that way, that has to take this into play. Something has to take into place that he's not in shape like he should be.
20 seconds to go here in round number 7, but Cedric Fields not working him like he should be. You can see the fatigue on the face of Gerald Nobles. As Kevin said, hands held low. Look at the mouth. Definitely very tired as we're getting close to that uncharted territory for Gerald Nobles. End of round 7. Another fairly difficult round to score. I've got to give it to Nobles again. He landed the left jab. He landed the left uppercut. Some right hands over the top. And that man, Cedric Fields, needs to pick it up a little bit. You see some swelling cut around the left Cedric Fields.
Well, I got, like I said, right now going into the 8th round, I got it scored. 64-66. I got Nobles. Donnie's starting to pull ahead in this fight. Donnie's starting to win the fight.
Judges cards. Round number 8, scheduled for 10. Gerald Nobles, unbeaten in the white trunks, solid white trunks, taking on Cedric Fields in the all black here at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Referee Jay Nady comes in. And he's gonna, well, there's the mouthpiece that needs to be in the mouth of Cedric Fields. Action resumes, light left jab by both fighters. Nobles holding the hands a little higher now, trying to land that hook. Every time you get inside, you get a worried feeling when the Nobles is going to throw that low blow again. There's that uppercut.
Well, I guess it's corner toe. Stay off the body because, you know, you're getting very close to getting disqualified. I mean, a lot of action downstairs early, and he's getting very, very close to getting disqualified. Fields is just like magic motion. He just keeps coming forward. He's not really doing nothing to win the fight. He's just doing enough just to lose the fight. We're starting to see that Fields has not changed up his game plan. He's not trying to land overhand right. Now, what Fields needs to do at this point in the fight, he needs to throw his body behind that right hand and stop just laying it out there because Nobles is coming over the top of that right hand like he's doing right now.
There's some nice body work, inside work by Nobles, staying busy on the inside. Those aren't very hard punches, but they're accurate punches. And I think he's trying to turn over a big right hand, Gerald Nobles.
Right now, if I was Fields, I would take the advantage of Nobles right now because Nobles is very fatigued. He's got his hands down. He's giving you more Fields, more and more opportunity to land a big overhand right. Fields has 9 knockouts. Why not try to get the knockout?
You know, he's throwing that right hand, like you said, and he's landing it, but he's pushing it rather than turning it over. You see a ponderous left hook attempted by He's got to
throw. It's called throwing your body. He's got to throw his body behind that right hand so that when he catches Fields, catches Nobles on the chin, Nobles lays down.
All right, Ray, referee Jay Nady warning Gerald Nobles. I think that Cedric Fields is a little fatigued himself, and I could see Nobles taking over this fight right now, too. I keep looking for Cedric. He keeps looking over to referee Jay Nady. There's a left uppercut by Nobles, right hand by Nobles. Fields coming back with some action. Left hook by Gerald Nobles.
He's got, but right now, what I believe that Nobles, when he goes home, he has to watch this tape and realize that, you know what? My conditioning could be better. The way I punch could be better.
Big right hand by Gerald Nobles landed.
And Fields didn't go anywhere. Eddie hit him with a left hook.
Beautiful shot to the body, though, by Gerald Nobles. A left hook and another left hook. Bounces just the head back of Cedric Fields on the ropes now. Left hook by Nobles.
But Nobles, I believe, is too tired to finish Fields. And this is why he can't throw the punches
anymore. Beautiful combination, though, by Nobles. Left hook to the body, then straight up to the head. Gotta be careful for those low blows, though. Gerald Nobles, he's been warned many times. 3 points taken away. Big round for Gerald Nobles. You see the underneath the right eye, some swelling. Cedric Fields probably in the most trouble that round of any round. Big round, in my opinion, for Gerald Nobles. He's pulling away now on my scorecard. See some of the action there. Look at a big looping right hand. There's the left jab, and there's the left hook. Fields comes back with a slapping left hook. Nobles measuring, and boom, right hand to the body, left hook.
But he's smothering his punches, he's falling in. He needs to step to the left or step to the right, throw another combination, begin again. But the thing that Nobles in his young career has got to learn is that when you throw your punches to set your man up, you have to step left or right. Don't smother your punches, because you can't get your man out of there. He has to practice his finishing touches.
You know, I could see right now Nobles getting him out of here. I think Cedric looked pretty fatigued and hurt that last round. We'll see. Right to the body goes Gerald Nobles in round number 9. This is uncharted territory for the youngster from Philadelphia. He's really working that left uppercut. There's a left hook. His back to you, Gerald Nobles. He's unbeaten. Got to be careful for those low blows, though.
With a record like his, there's a lot of stuff. I expect to see a lot more improvement from a fighter with 18-0 with 15 knockouts. But it's some things you have to work on before he looks to fight Kirk Johnson and the Black Rhino in the future.
Yeah, he's away from that, no doubt. Sure, no doubt about that. All right, Nobles steps back now. He landed some shots inside. He's trying to set up that big overhand right. There it is, and he misses it. There's the left hook by Nobles. But clearly all the punching, all the accuracy right now by Gerald Nobles.
Yeah, but he's missing some big shots, too, and he's also smothering his own punches. As you see, I believe he brings his hands up, his punches will be much more effective. He'll land pretty much the gravitational pull punching down, not punching from the wayside. He brings his punches up. He loses a lot of power doing that.
You know, I like him when he moves, though. I mean, you know, he has 15 KOs, but I like when he moves like this. There's a nice right hand by Gerald Nobles. Fields in some trouble. A left and a right by Nobles. Backing Cedric Fields up. That eye is pretty swollen.
But Nobles' condition is definitely in question here. He's very fatigued. He's very tired. I mean, look, he tries to go finish his man, then he has to step back. I mean, if he steps to the side, like right here, he's staying right in front of Fields with his hands down. Instead of punching, throwing overhand right, stepping to his right, or stepping to his left, throwing it again. And what's happening is that you look right there.
There he complains again about a low blow. And I think Fields just wants to get out of here. Kevin, he was almost looking to the referee each time there's a low shot. And he's calling that a knockdown. Jay Nady's calling that a legal blow and a knockdown.
Very smart. He's telling him, hey, you want to lay down? I'm going to count you.
I think he's pretty close to being ready to go. You see Nobles goes right back to the body of Cedric Fields. Fields misses with a left hook. Nobles trying to get some distance.
Fields knows just how to survive, and that's what he's trying to do here.
Left hook and another left hook by Gerald Nobles. He just stepped back and make Fields come to him. I think he can get him out of here. Setting up, trying to land that right hand or left uppercut. There he moves to the side, digs a right to the body. There's the uppercut and a right hand. Gerald Nobles showing well in round number 9. We questioned his stamina, and he's doing a good job here in round 9 against a stationary target in Cedric Fields.
Fields still not buckling. He's absorbing all the punches. I'll tell you, I'm shocked that Fields can absorb so much punishment in round 9.
Well, we mentioned he's been against some good opposition. You see, Nobles got to be careful for those low blows. Fields, that right eye is very swollen underneath. A little blood coming from the lip earlier. And another good round. 10 seconds to go in round number nine. Big round for Nobles, who scored a knockdown in it. Good round for that man, Gerald Nobles. Well, I have Fields trailing in this fight to the point where he needs a knockout to win. Some of those early rounds were a bit
strange. Meanness, got to put some hurt on. Got to put some hurt on.
Like I said, he's got a 12-11 record. He's not looking for that 500 mark tonight. He has another angle at it again. You know, he's throwing uppercuts. You know, he's throwing punches to the head, left and right, both hands letting go. Fails to absorb a lot of punishment, not retaliating. At any point, the referee could have stepped in and almost wanted to stop that fight.
Yeah, a little Sarah Bernhardt in Cedric Fields here tonight. He has been hit with some clearly low blows. Right back to the body goes Nobles. We're in round number 10. Final round. Kevin and I have Nobles ahead to the point where Fields needs a knockout.
Fields needs a definite knockout, but the way he's fighting right now, I don't think he's going to get one. He's looking for every excuse in the back door, as they call in boxing. You know, he has to want to win this fight at this point.
Gerald Nobles comes in here 18-0 with 15 KOs. Cedric Fields trying desperately to stay above 500, but he's really not trying desperately, as Kevin pointed out to you. He's 12-11 with 9 KOs. He has some power. Let's see if he even attempts it here in round number 10 from the Hard Rock.
He needs a big overhand right, Fields, to even get a knockout and to make Nobles pay attention to that right hand. He's not doing it right now. He's not even trying to put it in effect.
Well, he has 2 minutes to do it here in round 10. You see Nobles on the outside now. Takes a right hand to the body and a left hook to the head. Although he's ahead, he's not sitting back. Nobles still on the attack. Lands a left hook and a right hand, bounces back outside. There's a nice combination by Cedric Fields. Fields with a short shot. There's the left. All of a sudden, he gets busy.
Fields is not throwing any intent. No punches in front of bad intention. Fields just sticking his arms out there. He's in the fight. He's surviving. That's all he's doing at this point. He's attempting the final round. If he wants a victory, he's got to go for the knockout big right now.
Minute 25 to go, the 10th and final round. Gerald Nobles moving around, bouncing a little bit, landing some light shots. There's a nice right hand by Nobles. Cedric Fields not looking as desperate as we have him on our scorecards. There's a left hook to the body by Nobles. Left hook to the head. Cedric Fields shakes his head no, but doesn't reply with any shots, which he needs to be doing. There's a body shot, couple of them by Gerald Nobles. Desperation on the part of Cedric Fields in terms of winning this fight, in my opinion.
If Cedric wants to do something right now, what he needs to do is keep letting Nobles get confident, throw an overhand right with his body behind it, and I believe he can get Nobles out of it. Nobles very fatigued and very tired. Bounce wide open.
Well, this is his first time, you know, going 10 rounds. Coming up on 25 seconds.
And he did well, I tell you that. I mean, he's got to go home and watch his tape and realize that his conditioning has to definitely improve. His passion touches have to definitely improve. The smartest guy in the punches. He doesn't step from left to right. There's some definite things for him to get an upper echelon fighter that he needs to practice.
30 years of age. He's not going to get the KO, but he is going to get the W in our opinion. Oh, there's that big right hand.
Too late. You should have been doing that earlier.
Well, he was using up, I think, that strength acting, you know, trying to get the DQ. I still give that last round to Nobles, though.
I gave it to Nobles, you know, like I said, I got him winning this fight very easily.
96-91 is what I have, and I may need a mathematician, though, because they took, I think, 3 points away, I believe, from Nobles for low blows. See the end of the 10th round here. There's that right hand.
I got it 90-96. Did you see the punches here over the top? You know, finishing touches by Cedric Fields. Cedric Fields at the end. That is big, but he needed that in round 1, 2, and 3. A little too much too late. That's what happened.
go to the scorecards and we have a unanimous decision. Judge Carol Castellano scores about 97 to 89. And both judges Bill Graham and Paul Smith are in agreement, scoring about exactly the same, 96 to 90. All in favor of your winner, Gerald the Jodi Nobles.
Young man from Philadelphia.
Oh, definitely. There's a lot of fights, but a lot of lack of inexperience. You know, he needs more experience. He needs more gym work. He needs some stuff to work on. More fight footage to watch. Things he should have did, things that he didn't do. I believe the first thing is improve on your conditioning. Then those things will come naturally. Until he improves on the conditioning, those things will not happen.
Well, I said that to you. You remember in round one or two, I said the one thing you can see right away is some looseness around the chest area. And, you know, you can see right away that he can improve upon that a little bit. And then maybe drop, down to a little under 230 pounds. He weighed in at 237. So, but nevertheless, one thing that can't improve right now is the record. He's unbeaten, 19-0. Didn't get the KO, but maybe that 10 rounds would be good for him. That was his first time going 10 rounds.
Yeah, you know, even though it was the first time, I saw fatigue in like round one, two, and three. I mean, even the opening round, I see fatigue settling in. He needs to do a little bit more conditioning in the gym, lose a little bit more weight. He looked very flabby around the midsection. His chest